Speaking of athletes, I've helped around 350 kids get scholarships to colleges and universities all over the country.
Doctors.
And one of them I'm really proud of is the young man we have as a guest, our first guest today from Lincoln High School. My man, Sheldon Martin.
Hey, buddy.
What's up, my brother?
What's up?
Sheldon went to St. Joseph's College in Rensselaer, Indiana. Sheldon, tell me about Rensselaer, Indiana.
So, Rensselaer, Indiana is a small, you know, small place, but you got to make it work.
That's right, man.
College town, you know.
Uh-huh.
So, only thing there is a Walmart and a college, but, you know, we got to make it work.
Does Walmart have a club or anything?
No club. It's a small Walmart, man. Not a super Walmart.
Got super pool tables in there.
Everything goes
karaoke.
Everything goes on in college, you know. Everything goes on in college.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. So the campus has everything.
Yeah, the campus has everything you need.
Okay,
I mean, anything other than that is, yeah, it has it. Luckily, we have a Walmart, you know, so it works out, and, you know. Yeah. Works out.
You had a hell of a career out there. I seen his film, guys. I mean, he's out there blasting.
Wow.
He is out there getting it done. And so you ended up playing like an outside linebacker, strong safety type.
Yeah. So what I did was I played nickel. So my freshman year, I was a nickel and I was a returner. I was a punt returner, kick returner all 4 years. Freshman year, I played nickel, which is like a strong safety, outside linebacker. And then I played safety as well. Free safety. Basically, I was interchangeable. So I was the most interchangeable DB on the team. So I played whatever. The matchup, whatever the best matchup was, that's what I played. So.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Okay, so their best guy, he put Sheldon on it. He watched films all week. And then.
I'm one of the you know, prime-time defensive players. We had a couple of them, but I was most interchangeable. You know, everybody's not interchangeable, so that's what I was.
And the conference is a tough conference. Indianapolis, Great Lakes.
Yeah, Great Lakes. Yeah, we were in a conference with a lot of great teams. Big, you know, a lot of tough guys. Michigan, you know, not speed guys, but they're all huge. And, you know,
corn
so
boys,
yeah, huh? Corn fed guys. So you know, they're all huge. So it's a tough conference, you know, to play in. But
what division are they?
Two.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Division two. Yeah.
It's a good level of football. You know, a lot of guys think, you know, D2 is not a good level. A lot of us could play on the D1 level.
Oh, yeah.
You know. But it's a good level of football.
But there's a lot of D1 guys playing.
Yeah, it's a lot of D1 guys that play D2 now.
Yeah.
So, I mean.
Yeah, they transfer down. And,
yeah. And a lot of guys get, you know, Canadian League, NFL, other, you know. So, a lot of guys are making it.
Yeah.
It's a good level of football.
It's no joke.
Yeah, scholarship ball. So.
So, if you tell, you know, if you talk to these high school kids and they say D2, they freak out.
Yeah, they do.
But what would you say to them?
For the high school guys, I mean, you know, freaked out at first, but it's a way to pay for school. Like, you know, school is the most important.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
As far as, you know, D2 ball, this scholarship is not like, you know, you know, NAI or anything. D3, it's a good level of ball you can make, but most importantly, you get your school paid for, or you get, you know, get help or assistance with your school getting paid for. So that's, you know,
exactly.
It's a good, you know, that's what I would tell them.
Right.
It's that's most important. So.
And Wheels is winning one guy's degree.
Ooh.
Oh, man. In?
And I got a double major, business and sports management. Now I'm in grad school.
Oh, wow.
Same school. Yeah, so they have a five-year program.
Bro.
So basically, I knocked my 4 years out. And then I went back for my master's degree in business. So I'll be done in July.
Wow.
Yeah. So, I mean, I'm trying to get it done, knock it out.
I can see Coach Day-Day just smiling. You know, all proud.
Yeah.
Man, that's cool.
Yeah.
So, what do you want to do with business sports management?
Well, actually,
sports management or sports?
Yeah, sports management.
Okay.
Actually, Coach Rowe knows. This summer, I was working with the San Diego Chargers. So, I was in. Even though I'm a business guy, I was working in the communications department with public relations and media relations. So, basically, I worked with them this summer, and then basically just opened up some doors, you know. But as far as that, I didn't want to work in professional sports. College sports on the business side, you know, or the communication side, or just, you know, corporate America. But I would rather be in professional sports. So that's what I'm aiming for, you know.
So you had a good start with the internship with the Chargers.
Yeah, I had a good start, you know, made a lot of connections. I'm still connected with them now. I mean, they said I can come back this summer if I wanted to and intern for the whole year, or if an open position comes up, then basically I'll be on the top of the board for that. So,
and you're building that resume.
Exactly.
You know what this sounds like? Is Demetrius.
Yeah, Chapman.
From Mississippi. Story all over again.
Yeah,
you familiar with Demetrius?
No, I don't know.
Yeah, you guys' journey sound almost identical.
Okay. Is he
2004? 5.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so you're with the Oakland Raiders.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Okay. The Raiders, yeah, with Steve Mariucci and John
Raiders for a while, too.
Yeah, Raiders. Yeah. Yeah.
When did you graduate?
2011.
Okay.
So yeah, I played basketball too. I was on the state. I won state.
Oh, with Victor. Yeah,
I played state. We
right.
State,
okay. Yeah, yeah. I knew you looked
good. You got a picture of him. Right. Come on.
We won state 2010, yeah. 2011. We won CIF, but we lost in the sectionals or something against. I'm not sure who it was, but I mean, yeah, I was on the state team, so.
That was your senior year when y'all lost?
Yeah, that was my senior year when we lost.
Junior
year
we won
state.
Right,
yeah,
right,
and then,
right.
I mean, yeah, track, football, basketball, so I was a three-sport athlete.
Okay.
Yeah.
What'd you do in track?
Track, we went to CIF as well. I was a 100 guy. Made it to CIF for that. I did the 4x1, so 100 and 4x1. We went to CIF for that, you know, for both of those events. So I did that. And those are the events I did for track.
Man, I'm going to have to, you know, go through my file.
Number one for Lincoln, for football.
For football. Uh-huh.
Yeah, so, I mean, I'm pretty sure.
You bet on it.
Actually, my senior year, we made it to CIF for football, too, you know.
I got too many pictures.
We played Cathedral. We ended up losing to CIF, but, I mean, we made it there, so we...
That was the first show we went to CIF
since
you guys
back up.
Remember the quarterback got hurt.
Yeah.
What, like the early in the first quarter?
Yeah. Well,
and that changed the whole everything.
Exactly.
You know? Yeah,
exactly.
Man. So, you know, it wasn't like y'all were overmatched.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Most
you know,
it was
a key injury.
Exactly.
Man, it's different if you get injured in the fourth quarter.
Yeah.
Later.
Yeah.
Early in the first quarter, that's going to have some ramifications, bro.
Not Lincoln, you played running back,
corner. That's actually got me in the corner.
Yeah, Mel Galley.
And it's funny because I was supposed to play off. So basically, Coach Rowe helped me out. You know, I ended up.
Who helped you out?
Coach
Rowe.
So I had about eight D2 offers. I was supposed to play offense. So basically, I was like, whatever college, you know, let me play offense, I'm going to that college. I ended up playing defense. So I was mad, but I still was in a return game, so I wasn't too mad. But that's, you know, Coach Galley got me to playing corner, and then, you know, it's funny how I ended up playing defense in college, and I'm happy I played defense. You know, so, I mean, it worked out, you know.
So did you start right away?
Basically, my freshman year was crazy, because my freshman year, they were like, you know, we need some guys in the offense. So he came in, the head coach is actually a defense coordinator. So he was like, the offense coordinator wanted me to play running back, but the head coach was like, I don't care what nobody says, just play defense. But you know, we want you to have the ball in your hand so you could be in a return game. So I came in on defense, I was like third string. And I was like, oh, man. I was like, all right, so I'm not going to play. So I'm going to get it on my kick return. So I was returning kick return to practice, sprinting 100 yards in practice. So I ended up starting on kick return, but then when the first game came, I was starting at nickel. So, I mean, yeah, I ended up starting since my freshman year.
Wow, man. That's awesome.
Yeah.
You probably have a baby picture of him, right?
You know what I'm saying? Who'd you play part one for?
EP?
Yeah.
What jersey number were you?
I was number 36.
Don't start, bro.
You have me dipping way back, man.
I've been to Woodsonville for a couple times for EP back in the day.
Yeah.
There
we go.
Back in the day, yeah.
Absolutely.
There we go.
One thing we're going to do is look out for the community kids.
Right, for sure. Yeah.
You know, absolutely.
Yeah. And Will, so later on, I'll show you his highlight film from St. Joseph's University.
Man.
Let's
do that.
Man, that dude could hit. Man, he was out there balling.
How much you weigh?
I played about 195.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Then that could pack a punch. Oh, yeah.
Especially coming at you fast.
Yeah.
So
4.44. Yeah. I skipped that. I actually had a couple professional opportunities with, like, the Arena League. I just... I wanted to go the professional route,
because that arena can be kind of bad on your body.
It can, because
you're either getting hit by somebody, onto the ground, or into a wall.
Yeah.
You know, and where they make $100 a game.
Yeah, it's not how it used to be. They used to have contracts, but they went bankrupt back in the day. Now, you know,
it's like you're at your own risk
game,
here.
So,
you know,
it's not worth it to me. So
what did you do in 100?
So the 100, I was probably about like a 10-9, 11 flat.
Were you with Cannon?
Cannon.
Isaac Cannon.
Isaac, yeah, I was with Isaac. Okay, yeah, but right. He's younger than me. He was I was with Isaac.
What about Dominique Freeman?
Yeah, he's my year. He played more football. Okay, so he played ball too. So yeah, he was good dude. He graduated as well.
Yeah, he could run. He did football.
We both about the same speed. Yeah, he was on my 4x1 team. Played football with me. So yeah, me and Dominique, real cool.
I mean, that team was loaded though. You had Freeman. You had Victor Dean.
Victor, yeah, we had the football, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, Victor. We had Ronnie. We had Ronnie. We had Davon.
Ronnie's brother. I mean, Davon, we had, Aaron's brother. Aaron Simpson's brother.
Aaron Simpson, Jonathan.
Jonathan.
We had some dudes. That was competitive. Yeah. It was competitive. So I'm not going to lie.
Sean Wilmore.
He was at Jackson State. Yeah. I mean, yeah, it was a competitive team.
Both the twins.
Right? Yeah. It was competition. Every single day in practice, it was competition. And I was like, man.
Well, that makes you better.
Exactly. You know? Exactly. Yeah. That's what, you know, that competition was, you know, I never seen that. When I got to college, I was ready.
Man, so. 10-8, you said?
No, like 10-9.
10-9. Yeah. They can get a 10-9. 10 donuts and 9 donut holes. I remember that at the Winchell's.
10 donuts and a 9-hour nap. Right afterwards.
He's very witty.
Oh, yeah. You know, you got to watch the doors you leave open around him.
So, what was your best game out there, you'd say? Best couple games.
My best in college, right?
Yeah.
So my best game in college, we played a team called University of Indianapolis. We played them on CBS Sports on television. That, you know, for a D2 team, you know, for you guys that don't know, that's very rare. So we ended up going to 4 overtimes. Even though we did end up losing, you know, I did get the opportunity to play in front of my family all over the world. New York, they, you know, got to watch me on television as well. I mean, 4 overtimes, competitive game.
Oh, yeah.
So, I mean, that was my best game. That's one of my best memories as far as, you know, college ball. You know, so that, you know, that's just how it is.
Yeah.
You know? What about your best prep game experience?
My best prep game as far as...
That sticks in your head the most.
So, the...
Had the most
impact. So, yeah, my best prep game actually was... we played a team called William Jr. University. We were down. We were down 27-6 at halftime, and we ended up coming back to win.
Okay.
Yeah, so, I mean, that was my best, you know, as far as prep game, you know, made a couple of good plays, but, you know, that's just crazy.
So, okay, we'll be right back, man, on KBLK Radio on Coach Rose Show with Sheldon Martin. In a few seconds, be right back. Hey, we're back on the Coach Rose Show. This is Coach Rose. Got my man Iggy.
Yes, sir.
Got the icon here. Uncle Keith.
In the house.
Daryl Wheeler. Our first guest, Sheldon Martin from Lincoln High School. St. Joseph's College in Rensselaer, Indiana. Rensselaer.
But a Hornet for life.
Hornet for life.
Yeah, buddy. Definitely.
Big Al. Another Hornet.
Yeah.
Big Al. Big Al also. Big Al was on the swim team, right?
Yeah.
Swim team. I like to see those swim trunks, homie.
I was like,
so you were in competition for best body and build and figure and all that?
Not quite. Yeah.
Third runner up.
Third 400. Probably about the 8th runner up.
88.
But I had I wasn't like I am now, nowhere near it.
Bro was on the drowning team.
I was a water boy.
So, Sheldon, you had like a successful career. You just mentioned about you went to Cuba Bowl.
Yeah.
Then you go to CIF in football. And state championship in basketball.
Yep, state.
Hey, can you see his wall?
Oh, my God.
The house, or his mom's, no wall left. Mom's at the house. Got all
trophies
stuff.
Everywhere. Trophies everywhere.
I got to make room for those degrees.
Yeah, you got to make room for this. She actually just put one up in the little China case, with her. So, looking good. You know?
So do you get a lot of pictures?
Yeah, I have a lot of stuff. I have a lot of pictures. You know,
you don't need none of mine. Then.
As far as college, you know, I got a lot of, we have a team photographer, so I don't have any printed out or anything. But like as far as like on the internet,
on the phone,
we have pictures on there.
Okay, so. But your Lincoln experience, track, football, basketball, you have a bunch?
I don't have, from the state, you know, that was the year. I have a lot of pictures from the basketball team when we won state because that was a crazy experience.
Everybody but as far, was following.
Yeah, everybody was following. Yeah. So we have, but actually from like track, I only have a couple. Football, we went to the CIF, so I have a couple from that game.
What do you mean by a couple?
So, hey, you know,
a couple hundred?
Yeah. No, a couple hundred. I don't even know if I have, you know, probably about five pictures. I have one picture in the newspaper, only when we played, we went to CIF. Other than that, I mean, I don't really have a lot of pictures other than the basketball CIF game.
Really?
Yeah. I have a lot of pictures.
Oh, don't worry. I have a feeling you're
going to be trying to, you know, trying to see what's going on. Because when you said a couple, then you stopped at a couple.
Oh,
what, a couple two or a couple hundred?
Oh, no, no, no. I'm not sure. I'm not sure what's out there. But as far as I know, you know,
In your house.
In my house. Yeah. In my house, I don't have much as far as athletic pictures. But I don't know what's out there.
We're going to take care of that.
Okay.
So how early did Sheldon Martin pick up a ball or a bat or a track shoes?
It was funny is my thing wasn't even, my thing was taekwondo. So that was my foundation. I actually got invited to the Olympic team. I won the nationals, so basically I went to Puerto Rico, I went to Spain.
Hey.
Yeah. So that started my foundation, you know, with balance and everything. So my thing was taekwondo. I didn't pick up a ball until, I didn't start playing football until around sixth grade. So
that's kind of late.
Yeah.
Nowadays.
Exactly. Yeah. First day I went to practice, I had my hip pads in my knee plate. So, I mean, it was crazy. You know?
I think you do that all the time.
Yeah, so.
I'm wearing my hip pads right now.
I was wondering why he was looking kind of extra sexy over there.
You look a little hippie.
Case I fall. You know what happens.
So go ahead, bro.
Yeah, so I mean, you know.
Yeah, don't pay us no
more. Yeah, no
one else does.
So, yeah, football was my last sport. I started off with taekwondo, basketball, track, and then football was the last sport.
Wow. Well, do you still brush up on your taekwondo once a week and do a little something?
No, I actually don't. I made it all the way through, though. Like I said, I stopped. When I got offered to go to the Olympic team for taekwondo, I actually chose the reason why I didn't go is because I wanted to start playing football that year. So my sixth grade year, I got Olympic to go to the Olympic training team. I got invited, and I was like, no, I want to start playing football. So that's the reason why I didn't. Wow. But my mom actually still, she's on and off with it still. So we've been doing it since I started that when I was like three or four. My mom still is on and off with it.
So you got the black belt?
Yeah, actually, I stopped at a red belt because I was playing other sports, and I went there in the off season. I just never got my black belt, but I mean, I did the best. My mom, she still does it though. You know, she's on and off with it, but she's
still.
Your
mom is taekwondo?
Yeah, wow. Yeah, she still. I mean, in her off season, you know, when she's so busy, but she still does it though. It's the same place.
So football just hit you all of a sudden?
Yeah, because
my grew on you.
Yeah, because my. All right, so a lot of my family doesn't live here. So my cousin, it's my godbrother, Ronnie Yale.
Ronnie.
Yeah, that's my godbrother. So I always at his house every single day. He played football. So I'm like, I want to be like, you know, be like this guy. So my mom asked me, I want to start playing football. I was like, yeah, I want to start playing football. So I chose that route. And then, you know,
when, once you got out there, it was in for life.
As soon as I started playing, you know, I started playing at middle linebacker. You had me at middle linebacker like this. Sitting there, Coach D-Lo, you know, had me at middle linebacker. And I started that year. And then from ever since on, you know, I was a good athletic kid from taekwondo, a good balance and everything. So, I mean, ever since, you know, football was the way to go. I wanted to play, but I was better at basketball originally, but when I seen that, I was only about 5'10", you know, I was like, football is the way to go.
So you had to mention your mom, and so she does a lot of stuff still in the community, right?
Yeah, my mom is active in the community. She still helps at Lincoln. I've been going from Lincoln 5 years, helps at the VP Hornets. So I've been going there for about 12 years. She's on the board. So, I mean, she's really active in the community. You know, she's, you know, one of those individuals, which is good, you know. Yeah, so it gets passed on to me. So, you know, when I get whatever I have going on, of course I'm going to help out in the community, you know. So, you're right.
It's cool because, you know, none of her kids are there, but she's still.
And that's rare.
Yeah.
Because most volunteers are, you know, are parents.
Yeah.
They have kids playing.
Right.
You know, and that's just what it is. Right. And a lot of them, as soon as their kid leaves, they're gone too.
Yeah. You never see them again. Nope. Yeah. Well, tell us about your experience in the Cube Bowl, man. You know, when you're a little kid, that's something.
Yeah, of course. So, my my first cue ball, we played Otay Ranch, which was a new area at the time.
Right.
Like I said, I was at, this year, I believe I was probably a strong safety or linebacker. I mean, it was a good experience as a child. You know, we played at Southwestern College. It was like, oh my God, this is a big stadium, you know. So, I mean, it was a good experience. And then we also played Skyline as well, which was kind of like the rival. And we never played Skyline. So, it was like, oh man, this is crazy. We playing Skyline. So, I mean, it was a good experience just playing in the Cubo as a little child in the college stadium. So, yeah. It was a good experience.
When you first saw yourself in the paper, how'd you feel?
My mom actually, so I live in the Skyline area, but I play for VP. So,
oh, wait a minute, slow down.
Yeah, so I live.
What?
Yeah, is that
Man, that's like treason. High treason, man.
Two feet away from each other.
Hey, that's just what I did. You know, like I said, my godbrothers and everything play with VP, so I was like, I want to play with VP.
Right.
So I live, I still live in the same area. I still live literally right across the street from Morris. But I went to the gas station up the street. My mom picked up the paper, the Voice of Viewpoint paper, and I was from, I think it might have been from the cue ball, and it was a picture of me in there, and I was like, oh man, I think I might even still have the paper till today, I gotta find it, but.
Wait, you should still have it.
I should have. you know,
ain't nothing like the first.
Exactly. That was the first time I seen it, I was like, wow, that's crazy, but that was the first time.
Who were some of those guys that played with you in that cue ball?
I had a lot of dudes. A lot of dudes that grew up, like Meaty.
Rest in peace.
I mean, we had a lot of guys ended up, you know, moving out of the state. We had a lot of guys. Eric Jones, he was a quarterback when I was at Lincoln.
Yeah, Eric Jones.
The twins was on my team.
Wow.
Tyrell. Uh-huh. So I mean, yeah, we had some guys in that team.
And you know, it was cool that you guys went to Lincoln.
Mm-hmm.
Right after that, instead of, you know, I know some,
yeah, a lot of them. That's why it's hard for me to remember.
At least, you know, a core group of players stayed, you know, and went over to Lincoln.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
And that's getting rarer and
it's
rarer.
It's really rare. But if everybody that played for VP went to Lincoln, it'll be you know,
wow. CIF would get some kind of rule.
Yeah, exactly. You know, a lot of guys are branching off to other schools. So, yeah.
Cool, man. So, Rensselaer, Indiana, like, what's the biggest towns around there? Like, what's the closest?
Okay, yeah, so Rensselaer, Chicago is about 45 minutes going north. And if you go south, we have Indianapolis, which is about an hour and a half away. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, we're in the middle between two big cities. So, I mean, it's not that bad, you know. Mm-hmm. We also have Lafayette, which is where Purdue University is.
Oh, okay.
That's about 30 minutes away.
Okay.
So, I mean, yeah, we're in the middle of some big, big, decent cities. So, I mean, it's not that bad.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's just a car ride away.
My car was out here. So, you know, it was a struggle, you know, walking to the Walmart in -2 degrees in some Vans because I didn't have any boots. I'm in California. But I ended up getting some boots, but, you know. You gotta make it work.
What was the first time you saw a snowflake?
Well, actually, the thing about it, I seen snow because I snowboard. So I grew up snowboarding, so I've seen snow. But I go to Big Bear, which is, it gets about like 30 degrees, so it's not that bad. But I was in Indiana my sophomore year. It got to about, with the wind shift, about -15, -20. Around like December, and I was.
The wind is what gets you.
Yeah, the wind.
Just how I like it too.
Wow,
15 below.
Yes, how I don't like it.
Yeah.
It
was,
man, you and I are shivers right now.
What is wind chill?
It ain't chilling, man. Tell me you go to Mexican food. Serious wind chill.
Yeah. So what was like? Did you guys play? What was the farthest game you guys?
So the furthest game we play, the year before I got there, we played Sam Houston State, which is in Texas.
Good.
And they usually, B1AA usually win. But when I was there, the furthest game we played was probably in West Virginia, Charleston University, which is about, it was like 13 hours away driving.
On the bus.
Ooh. Yeah, so that's how far we went, the furthest I played. But they played further.
Right.
So.
And then your travels at the different schools you guys play at, they have some nice facilities out there. Like Charleston has great facilities.
Yeah. I mean, it's getting more competitive. Charleston, William Jewell University, University of Indianapolis. Actually, the Super Bowl was in Indianapolis about 2 or 3 years ago. They actually practiced at the University of Indianapolis. They built them an indoor dome.
Wow.
So, I mean, they're some pretty nice facilities at these colleges. Mm-hmm. So, Yeah, they're coming up. Yeah. With the facilities and everything.
The high school guys don't understand, man. They have, you know, they have Nike and Under Armour uniforms. Exactly. You got turf fields.
Exactly.
You
yeah.
got books.
Yeah, we're getting
books. They got girls.
Yeah, it's getting crazy. It's getting crazy. We now a lot of back in the day D2 schools wasn't, you know, provided with this, but now, you know, I had Nike cleats every year for my team, gear, different socks. We can go get socks. I mean, it's getting crazy now. You can get more and more things on this level, so it's getting more competitive and recruiting and everything. So,
when you were in high school, going back to like your sophomore, junior year, mm-hmm. when you're just starting to make a name for yourself mm-hmm. in sports, what were your goals? Like, where did you see yourself in college? Did you see yourself going to college? Did you see yourself playing like Division I football mm-hmm. or basketball or something like that?
Yeah, so I see myself going to college most definitely. Like, I was, even though, you know, I grew up in this area, I am fortunate enough. My dad, he has a degree, and my mom has a degree. So, I mean, I grew up in a household. I wanted to go to college, but I wanted to play sports. You know, I didn't want to make my parents pay for school.
Yeah.
Which they wouldn't have, probably. I would have been in the military, probably. But as far as college, I already knew I was going to go regardless. But I just wanted to play football, basketball. You know, going into high school, you don't know what you're going to excel in. So I just wanted to do something. Now, then I found out, you know, when I said I'm only going to be about 5'10", 5'11". I'm going to say football, I'm going to get big. So I was always I had no problem. You know, I was one of the bigger guys. I could in the weight room. I had no problem growing. So I was like, I'm just going to put all my work in here. My junior summer, I was in the gym. I went to 25 Fitness on the period every single day, Monday through Saturday. Put in the work. And so my senior year, my junior and senior year, I could excel.
Now, did you set your goals for, like, a Division I school?
Yeah. I had a lot of D1 looks. I actually had an offer from San Jose State, and that fell. That fell down. My guy, bro, Ronnie, I went to a San Jose State camp. He let me know, like, oh, yeah, they told me about you. They offered me. They actually fell through. I believe it was so long. I believe they had a coaching change or something. And then it was like probably April or May, and I had no offers because I already committed there. Mm-hmm. And then that's, you know, when Coach Roy helped me out, and then I ended up with around 7 D2 offers. And then I had Northern Colorado as well, which is D1 AA. So I ended up, you know, I'm blessed, you know, I ended up having multiple offers from a D2 level. Yeah, so.
So why did you choose? D2. What made you choose St. Joseph?
Well, for one, like I said, I wanted to go to a college. All of them wanted me to play defense. Mm-hmm. I wanted to go to a college where I was going to play offense. So this college was like, oh, yeah, you can play offense, you know, we need for running backs. I ended up playing defense. Yeah. So, yeah. I mean, that's really why I chose them. I mean, I wanted to play. I mean, and then also, it's a private school. So they have, like, as far as academics, like I said, that plays a big role in my family. So, exactly. You get the best out of everything. Mm-hmm. Learn how to communicate with diverse groups. So, I mean, as far as that, it was the education part, because it's a private school, small class sizes. You get the best out of everything. And then the, you know, sports as well. I wanted to play offense, and I was going to play immediately.
Well, what would have been your second choice?
My second choice probably would have been Northern Colorado, actually.
It's closer.
Yeah, it's closer. And actually, I wanted to get away. You know, you could always come back to San Diego. I wanted to get away. I wanted to try something new. So that's why, actually, I chose to go far, because I was like, you know, I could always come back to San Diego as far as graduating. So I wanted to get away. So it was a culture change, but it had to be done.
Are you here to stay?
Well, actually, right now I'm still in school in Indiana, and, you know, I'm really, since I'm young, I'm really open to moving as far as job opportunities, you know, especially in professional sports, you got to be ready to move, in that industry. So, I mean, wherever I get a job, as far as, if professional sports, I'm willing to move, but as far as business, if I work in, you know, corporate America, I mean, I'll probably come back to California, San Diego, but if I get a job in professional sports, I'm willing to move anywhere.
And that's probably what's going to happen.
Yeah.
Wherever they call, exactly. You just got to be ready to go.
Exactly.
You know, but you can always come home.
Exactly. Yeah. It's always home. I can always come back. So I'm young, so I can move anywhere at this point.
Where are the Indiana Pacers compared to where you're?
Yeah, they're in Indianapolis, so they're about an hour and a half away. Okay. So, yeah, they have Indianapolis Colts. So I've been looking at them as well. Mm-hmm. They don't really put out a lot of job offers or job opportunities as far as many of the other teams, but yeah, they're not far. And then we have Chicago Bears, which is about an hour away. Uh-huh. So, I mean, it's not bad. We have a lot of teams.
You ever heard of a place called French Lick?
French Lick.
You heard of French Lick?
The head from French Lick.
Oh, no. Yeah.
Larry Bird.
Larry Bird's from French Lick.
But have you ever heard of Larry Bird?
Yeah.
Big Bird.
I never heard of French
Lick. I bet it's smaller than Rensselaer.
I'm not sure
It's a lot of small areas.
Yeah, no, yeah. Walmart is smaller than Encanto.
Yeah.
But that's where Larry Bird is from.
Yeah, I never heard of that.
Yeah, he put it on the map.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I've never heard of that. It's crazy.
I guess it fell off the map.
I've been there for about 5 years and I haven't heard of that one time, so I don't know what happened with that.
Okay, when you go back, ask somebody.
Yeah, I'm gonna ask somebody.
French Lick. Let's go to French Lick. You want to go there, my man.
So, in the academics area, what is some advice you give these young guys out here, you know, like, that are in high school, mm-hmm. for when they go to college, you know, like time management? What's your advice to these guys?
So the advice is, my biggest thing as far as time management, that's a good point, time management. But my thing was, I did everything ahead of time. So I never procrastinated. I did everything ahead of time. So when it was time to travel or when it was time for a game to come up, I had my work done so I can prepare properly for the game. You know, so I did everything ahead of time, made sure I kept track with that so I could take care of, you know, other things. I just prioritize things.
Right.
Yeah.
Probably good at time management.
Yeah,
that's time, a priority.
Yeah, yes. A lot of people, you can get to college, that's a culture shock too. Time management, you got to play football, you got to study, you know, everything. But time management is a culture shock, but once you get a hold of it, you know, if you do it properly, you'll be good. You'll be good to go.
Now, what was your guys' schedule? Did you guys practice in the morning and then go to school, or go to school and then practice in the afternoon?
Yeah, so we went to what we did was we did like a morning lift. So it just depends if you're in the off season, in season. But in season, you'll have like morning lift on like a Monday or Tuesday, and then we practice after school. We didn't do the morning practice. We practiced after school.
So morning lift.
Yeah, morning lift.
And that was at what time, you think?
It just depends. If it's during season, probably around like 6. But if it's in the off season, you can go as early as 4:30 in the morning. Yeah, it's a grind. Really?
You would have never made morning lift.
I'm telling you, it's a grind.
I'm not a morning guy.
Yeah, I'm not a morning. I have to get used to it. Set three, four alarms to my mom to call me. Make sure you call me in the morning. I'm not used to this.
California,
yeah, exactly. I'm not. When I got, I actually was sleeping. My sleeping schedule was something. I was going to sleep at 4 o'clock in the morning, sleeping until like 2 in the afternoon. I was from California, and the time difference. It was so messed up. But yeah, it's a grind for sure.
Okay, so the morning lift, then what?
So you have morning lift, you go to breakfast, you go to your room, take a shower, then if you have time, take a nap, and then you go to class. And then after that, you go back to the locker room, get ready, get taped up for football. I mean, it's just
ongoing.
It's a schedule. It just depends. So from in-season to off-season, it's very different. Off-season is a grind. You know, you got way more things to do. But in-season is more mellow and toned up.
Okay, so during the season... Mm-hmm. Like, let's say you had an away game on Saturday. So when would you leave? Friday or Thursday? Or?
So if we had an away game on Saturday, usually we'll leave Friday morning around 7 o'clock. Uh-huh. It just depends how far the game was. But usually, typically, Friday morning at 7 o'clock. And it's funny because our coaches actually used to make us get in the ice baths that morning, especially in around November. It's about 20 degrees outside. So, I mean, you know,
that's an air bath.
Yeah, football guys are tough. So, I mean, you know, it's crazy. But yeah, usually we leave Friday morning, early in the morning, get there, eat and everything. Yeah, so I mean, yeah, Friday morning.
And so, like, football is really football and college, it's a job.
Yeah, it's a job. Schedule. Yeah, and actually, a lot of employers like that. Like, a lot of people I've interviewed, I had a couple interviews since I've been home. Mm-hmm. They see football, and they're like, oh, yeah, you know, even if you don't have work experience, that's your work experience. You know, they know it's a grind. They know you have to wake up, you know it's dedication, you're going to be on time, mm-hmm. and teach you everything, time management. So that's a job in itself. So, I mean, it's a full-time job, literally. I mean, it's tough to live out, you know, your 4 years without quitting or doing anything. You know, it's tough. It's a full-time job, for sure.
And then, talk to the kids about that are in high school now. Like, they, you know, everybody wants to go to the NFL.
Exactly.
But they can find you at a D2. They can find you at St. Joseph's in Indianapolis and all that. I mean, you got teammates or anybody in the conference, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so as far as NFL, I mean, talent is found, you know, anywhere for the most part. I mean, you have people everywhere, agents, different things like that. We have multiple people from our conference. A guy from University of Charleston, he played running back for the Kansas City Chiefs. We have a receiver from University of Indianapolis. He's a senior right now. He has multiple scouts. Mm-hmm. D2, even my best friend, he went to Western New Mexico, Larry Young, tall guy. He's going through the, you know, combine and everything. He got pro day at San Diego State. So, I mean, talent is found. You know, if you have it, it'll be found wherever you are.
Yeah.
What about that kid from that NAIA school?
Yeah, Cumberland.
Ran a 4-1.
Yeah, it's funny because my friend actually was at that combine. Was it yesterday? Yeah. It was Saturday. And he called me last night. Like, yeah, we had a dude that ran a 4-1 at this combine. Yeah. So he told me, and I was telling some of my friends last night, and they were like, no, he did it 4-1. It's too fast. Yeah. I was like, no, this is the guy ran 4-1. So, I mean, like I said, you can come from anywhere.
So, you know, based on his speed alone, it's going to get him drafted.
Oh,
you run that
speed. He's going to get an opportunity. He's going to get a chance. They're going to take a chance on him.
Oh, yeah. 4-1. And then, if he don't make the team, another team will give him
blazing.
A chance.
That's blazing fast.
So he's going to be around for a while.
That'll get you in a as a practice squad.
Exactly.
Well, what position does he play?
He's a return man.
Oh, he's a receiver.
He's a receiver.
And he didn't catch very many balls this year, but, you know, 419, are you kidding me?
We had 7 carries for like 200 plus yards.
Yeah.
And then like,
he had 25 catches or 15 or something.
Yeah, 25 for like 500 yards.
Yeah.
But, I mean.
He didn't light up the world, but.
He was sitting this way. His mom had to talk him into going to City College to play.
Really?
Yeah.
So he was a track star growing up.
You know, he was just kind of done with everything. So he was working. His mom's like, you know, go back to school and try it out. Yeah. And honor roll.
Honor roll?
Yeah.
With that kind of speed?
Yeah.
Man.
Well, 419 is all bad because you know what's going to happen now. You go to high school kids, go to Nike combines and stuff. Now you got to run a 4.3 instead of a 4.4.
Yeah,
everybody lies.
Like, what are you going
to 4.4?
Everybody does. You know, that's just how it is. You know?
This guy runs a 4.19 now.
You put a Rottweiler after me, I'll run a 4-1.
Put a donut in front of me.
I don't know. Well, yeah. Put a rack of ribs in front of me.
Yeah,
right. There you go.
Ribs. Yeah, I woke up.
Bubba's ribs.
Bubba's ribs.
Yeah, Bubba's.
Big Bubba. That's crazy. Man.
So,
yeah.
I was thinking about the barbecue.
I know.
Yeah, I'm
going
to do a food coma.
Exactly.
Hey, so what was your toughest transition when you got into high school or got into college?
So my toughest transition, for one, it had to be the weather. And two, just the time management. I didn't have home-cooked meals. I was from far away. I had no family. So, I mean, like I said, that's just something I went for. I just had to go for it. You know, I just jumped in the pool without nobody being there. I mean, missing home, being homesick, but, you know,
it's normal.
You know, so as far as, you know, time management, everything, the classes, it was just a different culture, but it's something I got used to, you know, something I adapted to. So.
Do you think playing multiple sports helped you with, like, time management and and adapting? Because, you know, going from sport to sport, it's an adjustment.
Nonstop.
Yeah, most
especially
definitely.
Playing taekwondo. Or,
doing taekwondo. Yeah.
Traveling.
Most definitely, and, you know, in high school, you gotta when you're a student athlete, you know, you just have to learn how to manage your homework, with your practice, with your game. So, I mean, in high school, basically, I was practicing. When I got to college, it was something I was already used to, as far as that. But when you get to college, it's a whole nother level, because you don't have anybody forcing you to go to school.
Yeah,
right. You know, you don't have anything, so you can wake up in the morning and be like, I don't want to go to, but you know, it's something you have to do. So, that was the biggest thing, you know, just nobody's forced me to do anything. You have to realize, like, this is something I have to do. So, that was the biggest thing.
Well, being in athletics, like, what kind of help did they give you? Do they give the student athletes?
Okay, so, basically, what we had was a program. All freshmen, you have study hall.
Mm-hmm.
You have to sign out. So, it's really strict. So, I mean, they help you with that. That's they good. Make sure that you go to study hall. At least, you have to get over a certain GPA in order to get out of study hall, which is typical for a lot of colleges.
Mm-hmm.
So, you have to have, I think it was like over like a 2.9 or 3.0 or something. But yeah, so as far as that goes, study hall was, you know, one of the major things that they made sure that we did every day.
Well, so how often did you call your mom?
actually, when I went to college, I spoke to my mom probably like once a week. You know, it wasn't typical. Most, you know, I'm a mama's boy. You know, my dad's a military guy, so he was gone a lot. But, I mean, I didn't call my mama. I ain't called her once a week. So I spoke to them rarely. You know, I was growing up, so. Yeah, and I was really busy. So I used to talk to my mom and once a week about, you know, talk to my dad once every 2 weeks or so. So it was a good time span.
But did you mention their names?
Huh?
Did you mention their names today?
Oh, no, I haven't mentioned their names. So, yeah, my mom's name is Kim Fuller. You know, I'm pretty sure a lot of people in the community know her. My dad's name is Shane Martin. He's on the south side of San Diego, so they're around the East Lake area. So, I got a little brother play for, he plays Pop Warner, runs track, everything. So, we're heading in the right direction.
So your pops play sports?
My dad, my dad's from Grenada. He's from he's from my island.
He played soccer.
He actually played basketball. Cricket? He moved to Brooklyn. He grew up in Brooklyn, so he played basketball.
Oh, okay.
My grandpa's a professional cricket player.
Oh, see, hey. Get out of here.
Grenada. He's from Australia, but he moved to Grenada, professional cricket player.
See there?
But my dad, he grew up in Brooklyn, so he grew up playing basketball. He didn't play football in Brooklyn. They don't really have football in their high school, so they don't really have football fields. So, basketball is the thing. Yeah. So, he didn't really play football. So, that's something I tried out new on my own. But now, my little brother is doing it, and he's doing well, quarterback.
Really?
He played quarterback in corner as well. He's young, though, about 10 years old. So.
What's his name?
Sean Martin. He plays for Old Tide. He plays for East Lake. He's pretty good. He runs track for Mercury, though.
Is he D on our side of town?
He runs track over here.
Are you going to the track meet next week?
I leave today. I'm going back to school.
Okay. Because Mercury is hosting Ed Morris.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Next Saturday.
Okay. Yeah, I know they practice there.
Shout out to Eddie Ford and the crew.
There you go. And what was your track?
I was instep, so that's he a trader for he a trader for Arnold Mercury, but it's cool though. We kind of
sounds like instep. Kevin Shields.
Yeah, Coach Kevin. He's
shout
my
out
coach.
To Coach Cam.
Yeah, he's my coach. So he a trader, but it's cool. it's still good track programs, for the youth. So it's good.
Yeah,
most definitely.
So little bro, have you seen him play in person?
I've seen him play. He scores all the time. He starts on defense. He starts at safety. He wears number one like I did. But he plays quarterback as well. So he's doing good. He's doing good. He likes it. He's doing well. He's going in right. And he's bilingual. He goes to a bilingual elementary. He's bilingual. He's only 10. He's bilingual.
What is it?
It's not Language Academy. It's in Bonita. If you get off on H Street, it's over there. So he's bilingual at 10 years old.
He can go to the taco shop and order.
Yeah, he can go to the taco shop order. He can do whatever. He can do anything. He can speak full blown Spanish. So,
wow.
Does he ever call you names?
he doesn't like it because at his school, the way they do it is they teach you full blown Spanish until you get to sixth grade, and then they start doing more English. So he doesn't. Since he does it at school all day.
English.
No, he speaks English. He can do that at home, but since he's doing it all day at school, he doesn't
want
to come
home. To speak Spanish at school, every class.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Is that right? Yeah. Teachers.
Yeah, so he doesn't like doing it when he gets home. So, it's good for him. He's going to be successful knowing two languages at that.
Plus he has an older brother.
Exactly.
That's setting it.
And then I have another brother. He got a scholarship. He runs track in Mississippi. Mississippi Valley State. He won CIF 2 years ago. He went to Eastlake, 110 hurdles. He won CIF. Shane Martin. He won CIF. He went to state. Got like third or fourth place in state. 110 hurdles. Now he at Mississippi Valley State, which is a D1 running track.
Okay. Dang, man. Yeah. Y'all just blessed with this athletic ability and those academic capabilities also. High five for that.
He was 3.0 in high school.
Now I'm 3. My MBA, my master's, I got a 3.7.
Are you gonna stop there or do you want to go on?
3.7.
I'm not sure. Now I have stuff I gotta take care of, so I'm gonna get my master's and then I'm gonna get my job experience and then from there, if anything makes me go there. But I'm just trying to get this job in professional sports.
What's mom think?
Oh, my mom likes it. Of course, she brags. She likes it. She's happy where I'm at.
Yeah.
She was happy when I got my bachelor's. She was happy when I got my diploma. But we're not content with things. So, we're not content. So we just keep moving forward and progressing in life. So that's what you got to do.
And I saw one of the perks of being a college football player with a degree and everything. I saw like a beautiful young lady in there. That never happened for me and Iggy, I think.
Well, I mean, yeah, you know, you never know. You never
shout
know.
Out to what's
your Shantae.
Shantae.
You never know who you're gonna find. You know, you can find your, you know, you find your potential wife in college, exactly. You know, or after, but you know, that's just how it works, you know. You found a good girl.
So let me get 3.7
and you hey, and then they have an education as well, so you know, you're set. You're set, you know.
But so she's lucky too, though. Right?
Yeah, we're both lucky. We're both lucky.
Not one sided.
Exactly. It goes both sides. Yeah. Both sides. You know, you don't have to worry about it. She's going to have a degree as well, so.
And was she a big Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle fan growing up, too?
No. I don't think so. She actually a college. She was a college. She played volleyball. She hurt her knee. She hurt her knee, so she stopped. She tore meniscus 2 times. So. She stopped playing college volleyball, but now, I mean, she's a science at St. Joseph's.
At St. Joseph's.
Yeah, she's in there. She's about 5'8", 5'9".
She's tall.
Yeah, so, I mean, she did that. She's from Chicago, though, so.
She's from Chicago.
But she got a whole different swag about herself.
She's a good girl, though. She's a good girl. So.
Hey, switching gears for a minute. Favorite book, favorite movie.
favorite book, I would have to say, I have a lot of good books, but I actually like, if you know who, I'm not sure if you know who Aristotle is, I don't know if you know who Aristotle, basically,
I know what Flavor the Dolphin
is. No, Aristotle, he has a lot of good philosophy about different things,
for sure.
Yeah, but as far as favorite movie, I have a lot of good movies, I mean,
but what one sticks out, or two, what two sticks out that you could watch anytime?
I actually like the Fast and the Furious movies. I like the Fast and the Furious movies. I like
Fast and my sister.
Yeah, I like the Fast and the Furious movies. I like Love and Basketball, of course. I like a lot of movies. I like Straight Outta Compton, actually. I like that movie as well.
Cool.
I can relate to that movie. I like a lot of movies.
And you have a range, right? There's no one type.
Okay. I watch all, and we're big movies. We're big movie people in my family, so we watch all, we see all the movies, you know.
Well, what about entertainer? Who's your favorite entertainers?
I like Kevin Hart. I like Eddie Griffin. I'm diverse with, it's no one person. I have a variety of, you know, entertainers, movies, books, I mean.
You know who Don Rickles is?
Actually, I know. I don't know that.
You're Cat Williams.
Cat Williams. When I first seen his dad.
Don Rickles is the white.
When I first seen Cat Williams. That's hilarious. But yeah, Cat Williams, I like Cat Williams.
Oh, man.
Yeah. He's funny. He's a funny dude.
Favorite rapper.
I like Kendrick Lamar. Kendrick Lamar.
He done took over.
Yeah.
Huh?
I like Kendrick Lamar, and I like in the game. Like I said, I'm listening to everything. I like the game, Kendrick Lamar.
Well, you know, he used to be a Grammy nominated rapper.
Grammy?
No,
Mammy. Yeah, I want a Mammy.
What's that?
Graham Cracker.
Yeah, I was on tour a little while. I opened up for Ice-T, Booyah Tribe, Digital Underground. When they had Tupac and Money B.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
See, you would have never.
Yeah, I
see
you.
But
know.
Why? Why would you have never known?
I was terrible.
He never told me.
I was really bad.
Never put it in the voice of viewpoint.
you can Google him.
No Googles. Good Googly movies, right?
Oh, yeah. He's
on the tour.
I tried, man. I tried. You know, so when you get a job in the NFL or NBA or anything, make sure you come and look us up because, you know, we're highly unsuccessful people. We need to get you. You know what I'm saying? Come get us, man.
Look out for you, you know? That's just how it works.
Trading for a couple of pictures.
Yeah.
Wheeler
is the most successful guy here, man. He's the man.
Wheels. I'm the nicest.
Second.
Third.
It's a third. So, favorite Ninja Turtle?
How'd you know about that?
I just talked to his mom.
Oh.
Leonardo.
Did you have those little tennis shoes with the lights on it?
No, I didn't. I never was that big of a fan.
I'm just playing. She just mentioned it real quick.
Your last, what was your last Halloween costume?
As a youngster?
Yeah.
I'm not sure. I used to go to church on Halloween. I'm not gonna lie. My mom used to make me go to church. She didn't believe in going out on Halloween. So I used to go to church on Halloween.
Is that right?
Yeah. I used to go to church on Halloween, so when I was a youngster,
church boy,
right here, right next to Lincoln.
Where at?
Faith Chapel. That's the church I went to right across the street.
Give them a shot.
Yeah, okay. Exactly.
What elementary did you go to?
I went to multiple. I went to Holly Drive, which is now it's where Faith Chapel was, and I went to Nubia. It's right across from Old Farrell. It's a church, but I went to Nubia. That's where I went. That's the elementary I went to. I'm pretty sure you know where it is. If you're driving on the backside of Old Farrell with a big dirt track, across the street is a church, and that's Nubia.
And it's the church connected to the school.
Yeah, yeah,
right?
Church. Pretty much all the elementary schools I went to was like that. You know, so I went to SCPA, Performing Arts School.
We shouldn't be surprised that you're academic. Success.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, it started at an early age.
Exactly. Right. Yep.
Well, Sheldon, man, we want to thank you for coming, my man.
Yes, sir.
You know, congratulations on your success out there in the community. And
we had a great time.
Yeah, we had a great time. Sure.
Very informative.
Whenever you're back in town, we got to get you back on here, man.
Most definitely.
Thanks for coming, man. Thank Sheldon Martin.